What are major threats for enterprise today, and what are they should be looking at, and why?
That's a great question. I think today the environment is changing so quickly, so the threats that we see in turn are changing so quickly. So some of the threats that we worry about today are with respect to information. We talk a lot about concerns regarding the confidentiality of information, data breaches, etc. But more and more we also need to be concerned about the integrity and the availability of data. So you want to be able to access your key data when needed, and you want to have the assurance that it is in fact the data that you developed. So attackers now, we've started to see them going into systems and either blocking your access to information through attacks such as ransomware, or in some extreme cases, they actually have changed the data, which leaves the entity questioning where to go back to, what state can they go back to find the data that is in fact the data that they developed. I also think one of the emerging threats we need to think more about is on a systemic perspective. So for example, now that we are all interconnected with digitization, with the increasing pace of innovation, Internet of Things, we can throw in all kinds of things that are evolving, we have a situation where your risk or the risk of one entity now affects the risk of another. So it's no longer enough to manage the risk of what you physically own. You have to think about everything to which you're connected. So your suppliers, for example, your customers, third parties, anywhere that you're connected to the internet can provide an opportunity for an attacker to attack you. So it's, when you think about systemic risk, it's the concept where an attack on one entity can then lead to cascading effects throughout many entities. So again, this leads us directly to the resilience conversation we talked a little bit about on the panel, which is that we have to partner to both understand our risk and then to manage it. So we're in a stage now where if you prepare individually, we will fail collectively. We need to figure out how to partner with roles and responsibilities to address these evolving risks.
And how do enterprise should deal with those data protections while keeping the privacy and increasing security?
It's a good question. Often security and privacy are looked at as competing elements or competing values, and in fact they're not. Privacy is just one other value that an enterprise should look at when securing itself. So it's not an if or an or, it's a balance between privacy and security and understanding what's important to you. From an entity perspective, the discipline that's required is to go through, in the data example, all of their data sets and make a value determination as to what is most important. And then from that perspective, think about how to protect it and ensure that it is resilient or redundant. Ensure that we can both have availability of the data, but also that we can ensure that it is in fact the correct data. So that does require some discipline to go through in a very traditional risk management approach, but nonetheless to go through all of your data as if it was a key asset and to think of it from that perspective, not just as an enabler of your service, but in and of itself as a key element. And from that perspective, think about privacy both in terms of breaches, the confidentiality of the data, but then also the integrity and the availability.
And how do you think those data law protections that are coming up will affect enterprise policies and the way enterprise deal with data?
You know, so do we need rules to protect privacy? Yes. I think the danger is that as we see a patchwork emerging around the world from a company perspective, you almost have another risk, which is now the risk of compliance with data privacy laws. So the United States is an example. Just a few years ago, each of the 50 states had their own law, and then there was a federal law. So as a company in the United States, it was quite difficult to comply and to understand what to do. We've started to harmonize that in the United States, and you start to see that throughout the world. But as some countries come online and develop their own regulations, we have that risk again where we have an alignment issue. And it almost becomes, as I said, an additional risk to comply. So do we need data privacy? Yes. But we do need to work together so that the different rubrics work together and that they're not patchwork and either duplicating or conflicting.
Do you think maybe a best practice worldwide or any, I don't think there will exist a data law protection worldwide adopted by all countries, but maybe some best practices to follow?
Yes, and I think that is a really an area across cybersecurity that's needed. We don't need to reinvent the wheel. There's a lot that is working in particular countries at the governmental level in this example, but within entities worldwide. So I think it's a challenge for all of us as a community to identify those best practices and then provide awareness of them. But you're exactly right. It's not, we're not going to find one solution that fits all. So it's much more a concept of harmonizing and aligning and making sure that we're not conflicting or unnecessarily duplicating, which can just raise costs to entities.